What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and in this video, I want to share with you the difference between frameworks and tactics, and why both of these are important, but you need to make sure that you're using the right one at the right time if you want to get the best results as you're going through your interview prep, and as you're going through life in general, regardless of what it is that you're trying to learn, where it is that you're trying to go. If you balance these two, it's going to make a huge difference. And so first, I want to break down what are these two things. So we have frameworks and we have tactics. And the big difference between frameworks and tactics is that you have the high level and you have the low level. So the framework is the thing that's at the high level. The framework is the thing where, you know, I've put this kind of roadmap in place, or I have this strategy that I can apply in lots of different scenarios. And then the tactics are the specific little individual nitty-gritty pieces that are going to get me there. And so let's think about this in terms of weight loss or fitness for a second here. The general strategy, the general framework might be that I need to eat fewer calories than I burn on a daily basis if I want to lose weight, right? It's a very simple tactic, it's a very simple strategy and very simple framework. But then the tactics are how I actually go about starting to achieve that, right? So the tactics are gonna be things like, okay, well, I'm gonna drink a protein shake in the morning because protein is satiating and I'm not gonna be as hungry. I'm going to eat, you know, I'm gonna get low fat, whatever, because it's gonna be lower calorie and it's gonna help me meet those goals. I'm gonna eat lots of vegetables because it's gonna make me full and I'm not going to struggle as much. But the problem is that if we just focus on those tactics, it's not gonna get us there. Because if you think about it, the tactics help us achieve that overall framework, that overall strategy. But without the overall strategy, the tactics are meaningless. Because what if I apply the tactic? What if I say, okay, I'm gonna have a protein shake every morning? That's great, but then I eat an entire pizza for dinner, right? It doesn't actually help me. And in the same way with coding interviews, what we tend to do is we tend to focus on the tactics rather than the overarching framework. And so we try and fit these tactics in, and we try and do these specific tactics, which are important, without actually learning the strategy and the framework that they fit into. And so I want to talk about, what is a specific example of this? Well, think about every time you solve a LeetCode problem. Every time you solve a LeetCode problem and you look at, like, what is the solution to this particular problem on LeetCode, that is a tactical approach, right? You are saying, tactically, how do I solve this one problem? How do I approach this one thing, and how do I learn this one approach that is going to help me in this one situation going forward? And so that's helpful. It helps you to solve that problem, but it doesn't help you with the bigger picture. And so what we want to start thinking about is putting the framework in place, putting the overall strategy in place, so that we can then start to fit in the tactics. And so I want you to think about this for the purposes of coding interviews. The basic framework might be, what is our interview prep roadmap? So when are we going to focus on different topics? How much time are we going to spend on different things? How are we going to make sure that we're covering all the different areas that we need to cover? And so, for example, if you go to bytebybyte.com/roadmap, I believe, or just Google bytebybyte and roadmap, you're going to come across, there is an article that I wrote on developing your coding interview roadmap. And so if you have that roadmap, then you're able to go and you're able to say, okay, let me start actually building in the tactics. How am I going to approach this on a day-to-day? How am I going to approach this on a week-to-week basis? How am I going to dig in and make sure that I'm actually accomplishing the things that I want to? And in the same way, when we're solving actual problems, how are we going to take a strategic and framework-based approach to this rather than just focusing on the individual tactics? Can we look at, like, what are the strategies that are going to work for all of our problems and not just what are the strategies that are going to work for one specific problem? So, for example, like, in terms of a basic framework, make sure that you're finding a brute force solution to the problem. Make sure that you have strategies for optimizing that brute force solution. Then code up your solution. Then test your solution. This very basic framework, now we can say, okay, how do things fit into here? How do the specific tactics, like breadth first search, how does a sliding window, how does all of these different things, all of these different algorithms are specific tactics. How do those specific tactics fit into the bigger picture? And this is what I want you to start thinking about, because if you can think about the framework first, if you can think about the over-level, overarching strategic approach and then fit in the tactics, you're gonna be way more successful. You're gonna get way further in your interview prep than if you just focus on, let me learn the individual tactics. And so I want to keep this short and sweet. Hope this is really helpful for you. If you enjoyed this video and want a ton more like this and want me to show you how to take a more strategic approach on some of these specific problems, come over to bytebybyte.com/50questions. You can download my free 50 coding interview questions guide, where I'm going to take you through video solutions for the 50 of the most common coding interview questions. And I look forward to seeing you all again next week.